Hey geeks, Mod Tim here with tonight's episode of Star Trek Season 3, Episode 4, The Enterprise Incident. This is a great episode. It's really well done. It has great pacing, it has great tension all the way through. It's probably in my top 10, to be honest with you. Now, to back up a little bit, so in Season 1, we first encounter the Romulans. It's within the first couple of episodes. And then it's a big deal because at this point we hadn't seen Klingons and we hadn't even seen other Vulcans. So when we do finally see the Romulans, it's a huge reveal because they look just like the Vulcans, and then it kind of creates tension with Spock. So after we encounter them, we do encounter the Klingons, and then they become a reoccurring villain throughout the series, but we don't see Romulans. And now finally 2 years later, into Season 3, we finally have not only the second appearance of the Romulans, but it's their last appearance until The Next Generation, where they have a huge role in that series. So it's just kind of an interesting concept that they're such a well-known species, but if you go back to the original series, they're only in it twice. Now, a little interesting tidbit for this one is when we first encounter them in this episode, they're in Klingon ships. And there's kind of a throwaway line that Spock has when they first pop up, because Scotty thinks they're Klingons, and Spock's like, no, it's just Romulans using Klingon technology. So there's a big conspiracy theory behind that, that first, since we only saw them the one time, the model ship of the Bird of Prey had been destroyed. And so the producers just kind of panicked and threw a Klingon ship in there, because they had just recently made a new one, so they kind of wanted to show it off as well. And then a second conspiracy theory is that when they wrote the script, that they had already known that, and so it was already in the script, that the Klingons and the Romulans had made like a treaty, which again is explored more in The Next Generation, and they kind of traded Klingon birds of prey for Romulan cloaking technology. It doesn't really matter. It goes both ways. It's kind of a throwaway, cheesy line. But it's kind of interesting. After this, we get into The Next Generation, where they're fully established that they have their own ships. But now we do see the Klingons using cloaking technology, so it's kind of interesting. It's also, at the end of this episode, we see the Enterprise steal that cloaking technology and actually cloak, and then kind of escape. And then, boom, the episode's over. Which is really interesting, because, again, once we get to The Next Generation, the Romulans and the Federation have that treaty that the Federation is not allowed to use cloaking technology. And I don't think they ever reference this episode. And then I don't think we actually see the Federation use cloaking until Deep Space Nine, where the Defiant has it. So it's just kind of an interesting little piece of technology that's just thrown about here and there, but nobody quite knows what to do with it. Like, I don't think it's until we get into the movies where we start realizing that they can't fire with cloaking technology. So, like I said, at this point, I don't think that they've narrowed it down or they pinpointed exactly how they want to do it. Also, it's interesting that, so this is the Romulans, but this is the first time that we've seen a female commander, or at least a captain of a vessel. We still haven't seen that for the Federation yet. We've seen women in high positions, but we haven't actually seen them with their own ship. And even for the main characters, that's not really something big until Voyager with Captain Janeway. Now, I know it's the 60s, and a lot of the shows don't connect, or each episode doesn't really connect. But it'd be interesting to like write down all of the dates that they throw out, because in this one, they ask Spock, how long have you been in the Federation? And he says that he's been in there for 18 years. And I think Kirk has said 11 years, which I think Spock also said he was with Captain Pike for 11 years. So there's a lot of dates out there that they haven't really fully established, and it seems like they keep retconning it back to kind of fit their needs wherever they need it to. Because then once we get into like the 2009 reboot, Spock and Kirk come out of the Academy at the same time. So it's just kind of interesting how things shift around in there. So all that being said, like I said, it's a great episode. It's really well done. I kind of wish we'd seen more of the Romulans, but they're handled so well in The Next Generation that I like them there more. But it's good to see how firm that they had the character set this early in the series. Whereas, like, Klingons are just everywhere. Like, they're never the same episode to episode, even. So, tomorrow's episode, And the Children Shall Lead. For this one, what do you guys feel about the Romulans? Like, do you guys like them? Do you think they're a cop-out? their connection to the Vulcans. Just let me know in the comments below. What do you guys think about the Romulans? And I will see you guys tomorrow.